I do have many, many personalities, but it all comes from one man. That's me, Dr. Sam Proper, Lord Professor, at your disposal. And I do love to experiment, obviously. My music doesn't feel like an experiment at all. It comes naturally. But, you know, obviously there's some experimenting going on, and I like to touch a lot of grounds and make fusings, you know, combinations, stuff like this, the electronic and organic stuff. That combination I love. But it just comes from the live circuit, what I used to play and perform in when I was younger. And to electronic music, it kind of blew up into the fuse of the both. And experimenting is definitely part of the game, but I do have to admit that stuff just comes from instinct, animal instinct. I think people should definitely focus on doing something authentic and original, like making love to a T-Rex. Why not, you know? Sorry. It's hard for me to stay serious. I like my music to be raw, but it mostly has to do with the combination of organic drums and an 808 or a 909, guitars and synths, vocals and the cinematic samples and street samples I take. I like to walk around with a dictaphone or a little recorder, especially because of the sentiment and nostalgic stuff. Because I travel somewhere and I go like, wow, it's great out here. And then I start to record crazy sounds from my surroundings, and I always use them. And that's what makes it sound raw. The live aspect, the organic sounds, the old school, more traditional instruments, which are combined with the crazy scientific synthesizer tools that you present to me, you know, to fuck around with. Fuck. Attitude? I don't have an attitude. I might look like a dinosaur, but I'm still quite young at heart. Not what I normally do, but try to reconstruct some of my brain cells, which I've lost over the years. And I'm hoping that this will make me a bit smarter again, you know? I've been playing records since 93. I've been making music since I was 9. And I only put stuff out in 2009. I was born in 77, so do the math. Like I told you, my brain cells are too little to actually do this little equation. But I think I could have released stuff earlier. So maybe I'm just catching up. But I love to put out a lot of tracks, and also because You know, to be a perfectionist is only cutting back on the creative process itself, you know. Me, because I come from a live circuit, I like to jam and do quick bam, bam, boom, bam, damn, boof, and not waste too much time with just, you know, scrutinizing every detail and blah, blah, blah. I have the feeling that time is passing and it's running and it's running out. So the time it sometimes takes for a label to actually release the track you produced, it can take so much time. I'm not going to sit on my hands in the meantime. And I also love to jam and collaborate with a lot of different artists around me, which I meet along the way, or small-time labels by teenagers who are just like very enthusiastic about my music. And they book me and they bring me to a small, cute little venue and we have a blast. And then I see them fucking around in the studio and I'm like, ooh, I want to fuck around too. And then we jam and, you know, I like to keep it like vivid, you know, motivate other people, do a lot of collabs and make sure that house music, you know, remains. Because that's the way we do it together. How's my hair, by the way? Because I'm still kind of shocked with this burnout. Is it okay, though? It's a bit messy, right? Oh. Oh, help. Lord of mercy. My mind. Ow. My mission in this world, I think it's supposed to be about putting the music I feel and got running through my veins on the map. Presenting it to you boys and girls, because music history, you know, it helped me so much in days of having the blues that I'm sure that even my stupid tracks can like motivate people or help people or give them a good feeling in a rough momentum, you know. It's about the blues eventually. You go to the club, you go, you put on your headphones, you play a record at home or a CD or your iPod or whatever people use today. But you do this because you want to, you know, you want to feel comfort. You want to have like something to relate to and cry about or feel ecstatic about or let yourself go and forget about the everyday trouble, blah, 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 blah. We've heard it all before. But music is the blues, and we are all looking for love instead of grief, right? Speichel. Rain shoot. It's important to stay like a little bit jolly, you know, and happy and make fun. And be deadly serious at the same time, I guess. Most of the tracks I make are about girls and the love I feel for them and the way to persuade them, you know? And this is funny, but it's also deadly serious, of course. Love is the message, and the motherfucking message is motherfucking love. Music brings us together, right? That's love, right there.